Hello everyone, welcome to the new session on how to read an AWR report. So previously we have been posting videos on how you can tune your poor performing Oracle SQLs by using the best indexes, joins, hints, etc. So there has been request from some of our subscribers to post videos on how to read an AWR report. So this is an effort in that direction to acknowledge that request. So here we are on our first case study of how to read an AWR report. And in the forthcoming videos, I will also publish how you can read the AWR report detail-wise with regards to each and every section. So let's get started. You may have frequently encountered this scenario where a customer or a client has shared you an AWR report and have asked to diagnose what wrong has happened with the database. So here we are going to discuss on one of the scenario that has degraded the database performance, which is high discretes or IO. So this is the first section which you should always see. What is the number of cores the database has? What is the platform? What is the elapsed time the database has covered? So coming to the elapsed time, one of the frequent mistakes that most of the people does is we pull an AWR report for a longer interval, like 30 minutes or 1 hour, even though the issue is constrained within 5 minutes or 10 minutes, or say even smaller, like 1 minute or 2 minutes. So if you pull an AWR report for such a long duration, you may not be able to get the exact cause of what has happened with the database. So my recommendation is always to pull a smaller AWR report of 10 minutes, because that's the minimum what Oracle gives, and ensure that the issue covers within that 10 minutes time frame. The next thing which we will see is the DB time. In this case, the DB time is 1698, which is definitely high. And that concludes that there is something wrong that has happened with the database. But how to determine that whether the DB time is higher or not? So there is a formula. Your DB time should always be less than the number of cores into the elapsed time. This is the ideal case. In our case, the number of cores is 40 and the elapsed time is 10 minutes. So this means the database can process 40 into 100, that is 400 minutes of work without getting overloaded. If you're asking database to do more work outside of 400 minutes, the database will start getting overloaded. So in our case, the DB time is 1600, close to 1700. So this means that we are asking the database to do 4 times more work as compared to what the database can actually process. So this means there's something wrong with the database. The second thing which we can see is the summary of the events. In this case, we see DB file sequential read as the top one with an average wait of milliseconds 9. And it has consumed 47% of the DB time. So the top one is the DB file sequential read. So DB file sequential read is nothing but reading the data from the disk and putting it in the buffer cache. So this has contributed to the top one, close to 50%. Second one is the CPU, which is 16%. So one of the most frequent wait events that we see in the top two is certainly the DB CPU and the DB file sequential read. If you are seeing these two wait events, then it means you're not having much of an abnormal event that is going on. But again, if you're having more DB file sequential read, it means the database is consuming time doing the disk reads or IOs rather than reading it from the buffer. So when you read the data from the buffer cache, your event will be DB CPU. So DB CPU basically means spending time on database, reading from the buffer cache, and also to do some of the background processes. So the ideal case would always be your DB CPU coming on top one, and top two should be your DB file sequential read. Because reading the blocks from the cache is much faster than reading the blocks from the disk. So that's why DB CPU should always be on the top. And yes, you also have to ensure that the DB time doesn't cross number of cores into the elapsed time. The third wait event is the log file sync, which is 10% commit. So in our case, there is certainly a 10% of commit, which is slightly higher. It should not be. Commit is a wait class, which is expected in each and every Oracle database. But the percentage of 10 is slightly on the higher side. So in this summary report, we can say that there has been certain problem with regards to the user IO. And if you see the average wait in milliseconds is 9. So this is also an acceptable value. Depends on what type of disk storage you have. If you have an SSD, the 9 milliseconds is certainly a big higher number. In this case, the storage is not SSD. And looking at the past good time AWR report, a DB file sequential read with average milliseconds of 9 is acceptable in this case. Next section that we should always see is the foreground wait events. In this foreground wait event, you can clearly see that again, the DB file sequential read is on the top one consuming 47% of the time, and average wait millisecond is 9. And second one is the log file sync wait event, which is consuming 10% of the database time. And if you see here, the average millisecond is 22. This is certainly a very high number with regards to the average wait in milliseconds. Now, why this happens is also we are going to see in the forthcoming slides. Looking at the background wait events, if you see the DB file parallel write has consumed 46% of the time, but the average wait in millisecond is only 2. So it means there is no issue in writing to the data files. So write operation is not impacted. Again, second event is log file parallel write, that is reading to the redo logs. If you see, the average wait in millisecond is only 3, which is a good number. So it also means there is no problem in writing it to the redo logs files. So the background wait events look perfectly fine. If you look at the SQL order by elapsed time and the reads, you see that the first query has consumed 23,000 seconds of the database time and has done only 4,000 executions. And this is the SQL ID. I have masked the SQL ID as ABC since this is a template report, and it has consumed 23% of your database time. So this means this SQL ID has consumed the maximum amount of resources from the database. And if you look at the SQL order by reads, you see the same SQL ID again coming on the top. And if you see the number of physical reads, it is 4 times higher than the top 2 SQL ID. This is 455K and this is 1600K reads. And that too, it covers only 4000 executions. If you also see the SQL order by cluster wait time, you see the same SQL ID ABC is coming on the top one, and the top two has consumed only 435 seconds of cluster wait time, but this SQL ID has consumed 6000 seconds. So this has also contributed to the cluster wait time. Now, why we are interested in seeing this SQL order by cluster wait is because if you look at the top four wait event, you can see GC buffer BC acquire, 7% is the cluster weights. So that SQL ID has contributed more towards the cluster weights as well, which has further slowed down your database. Reads by other session is again a user IO wait class. This is again the same scripts from different sessions are reading the same blocks. That's why you're getting the reads by other session. And this also falls under the user IO. And that is why your SQL ID ABC is the culprit. Now the solution for this will be you have to fine tune the SQL ID ABC so that it consume less reads per second. So in this case, it has consumed for one execution, it has taken 400 reads per second, which is significantly higher. So you have to tune so as to ensure that the reads per second falls below 50 or 100. Or you can also ensure that the number of execution in a 10-minute window doesn't exceed 4000. You can restrict it so that the number of execution comes down to around 500 or 1000, so that you can reduce the load by 1/4. Another solution for this would be if this SQL ID is already running with the best plan and there is no further fine-tuning that we can do. And also if we cannot stop the number of executions from coming in, then we have to increase the network bandwidth so that it can process the IO request much faster. Say for example, the network bandwidth was 1 GB per second, then we have to increase the network bandwidth by 10 GB per second so that the reads per second, even though if it is 400, it will be processed much faster. So that is it. We have completed the first review of how to read an AWR report when your issue is related to the high disk reads or high IO. I hope you like the session. And if you really do, please feel free to like, share, and comment as well. See you soon with another set of new video. Thank you.